ஆழ்வார் எம்பெருமானார் ஜீயர் திருவடிகளே சரணம், ஜீயர் திருவடிகளே சரணம். டுடே வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு டிஸ்கஸ் அபவுட் சூசிங் கைங்கரியம்ஸ் ஓவர் வேர்ல்ட்லி டியூட்டிஸ். திஸ் இஸ் அ கண்டினியூஷன் ஆஃப் அவர் ப்ரீவியஸ் செஷன். லாஸ்ட் ஏகாதசி we discussed about the conflict management in karmam and kaitaryam, and we are going to further discuss on this topic a little bit more to understand about kaitaryam and how some great personalities have performed kaikaryam and how we can learn from that and practice it in our life. Adiyan have to appreciate Srimati Shyama and Sri Prem Swami. Both of them are doing wonderful arrangements for Bhagavatas in Sydney to discuss Satvishyams, provide a platform both at their home as well as through these satsangams to engage in Bhagavad Vishyam even in difficult situations. So that is something which should be inspirational for others as well. So we saw in the last session about karmam and kaikaryam. Just to recap a little bit, we saw from Acharya Hridayam the definition of karmam and kaikaryam. Acharya Hridayam is a beautiful grantham composed by Azhagamunavar Perumal Nayanar, who is the divine younger brother of Pillai Lokacharya. In Acharya Hridayam, Nayanar brings out the heart of Nammalvar. Acharya here indicates Nammalvar. Hridayam is his heart. In this grantham, Nayanar beautifully explains the greatness of Nammalvar, greatness of Thiruvaimozhi, the inner meanings of Thiruvaimozhi Pasurams, and so on. In this grantham, he explains the difference between karmam and kaitaryam. So karmam relates to bodily activities mainly, and kaikaryam relates to atma related activities mainly. Though body cannot act independently of atma, and atma cannot do anything without the body. Now here the emphasis is on body for karma and on atma for kaikaryam. Even karma has an impact on atma. Similarly, kaikaryam has an impact on the body as well. Still, the emphasis, karma is based on varnashrama dharma, which is mainly based on bodily divisions, and kaikaryam is applicable for everyone. It is based on the atma swarupam, the true nature of the soul. So everyone can serve in some manner. When we are in this bound situation, our service to Bhagavan Bhagavatas will be still bound by bodily rules, like the example we saw Hanuman with his great abilities, his physical abilities, he could go and bring Sanjeevani herb, the mountain itself, which was having the herb. But we cannot do it, saying that I can also do Kaikeriyam like Hanuman. But at the heart, we can try to develop the mood of Hanuman. We can try to dedicate ourselves fully as Hanuman did. So there are limitations based on body even for Kaikeriyams. We cannot think that everyone can do every Kaikeriyam. But still, everyone can do Kaikeriyam, some Kaikeriyam. That is the important point to be understood in Kaikeriyams. Karmam we saw enough in the last session, how different varnas, different ashramas have various responsibilities and duties and how they have to be fulfilled without fail. Similarly, Kaikeriyam also need to be fulfilled for our own benefit, for our own improvement in this spiritual life. But that is not the main goal. The main goal of Kaikeriyam is to give pleasure to Bhagavan and Bhagavatas and Acharyas. So that goal need to be fully held in the mind while performing Kaikeriyam. In this respect, Adiyan wanted to highlight from Sri Vachana Bhushanam the ideal examples for Kaikeriyam, the personalities who have manifested exemplary Kaikeriyam towards Bhagavan. In 85th Sutram, Pillai Lokacharya explains in Sri Vachana Bhushanam, actually from 80th Sutram, it all starts, where in 80th Sutram itself, Pillai Lokacharya highlights who are all the ideal personalities in with respect to pursuing Bhagavan as Upayam and having Bhagavan as Upayam. Here Upayam is the means and Upayam is the end or the goal. So Bhagavan is the Upayam for us. He is the one, his lotus feet is the means for us. And once we accept that Bhagavan is the means and we pursue him, the result we attain is Bhagavan himself, and after attaining him we have to engage in Kaikeriyam for him. We have to serve him. So this is Upayam and Upayam. Upayam is the means and Upayam is the end result, the goal. And in this 80th Sutram, Pillai Lokacharya explains that for Upayam, Pirati, Sita Pirati, Draupadi and Tirukkannamangayandan are the ideal examples. And for Upayam, Upayam always means Kaikeriyam. So for Upayam, Elaya Perumal, that is Lakshmana, Periya Udayar, that is Jatayu Maharaja, Pillai Tirunarayur Arayar and Chintayanti are the ideal examples. We will see briefly both Upayam and Upayam. Though for us Upayam is the context. Kaikariyam is the context here. Just to understand the sutram, we will just see what Pillailokacharya is explaining. Manavar Mamnigal has beautifully given various quotes from the scriptures and explained it in a very elaborate manner. It is a very important section for us to understand. First, for Upayam, Pillailokacharya says, Pirati, that is Sita Pirati, Draupadi and Tirukannamangayandan, they are the examples. We should be like them in pursuing Bhagavan as the Upayam. So we have a goal to attain Bhagavan, and for that, what is the means? Shastram says there is Karma Yogam, Jnana Yogam, Bhakti Yogam, Tirunam, Sankirtanam, Divideshavasam, making garlands for Bhagavan. There are so many means identified in Shastram, but they are all meant for certain people who think that they are the doers. Once we give up the doership, once we accept that Bhagavan is everything, He is the one who controls everything, He is the one who is leading everything, then we will accept that He is the one who will help us as well to attain Him. So for us who are thinking that Bhagavan is everything, who are we going to look up towards? And that is where Pillailokacharya highlights that Pirati, Draupadi and Tirukannamangayandan. So Pirati, Sita Pirati, when she was in Lanka, held captive by Ravana, with her powers she could have easily destroyed Lanka and returned to Perumal. In first place, she could have even destroyed Ravana when he tried to capture her. At that time itself, she could have destroyed him. But she did not. She wanted to go to Lanka and she wanted to help the Devastris, the celestial ladies who were in Lanka. Hence, she went there, and then she could have easily herself destroyed all the Rakshasas, including Ravana, and brought back all the Devastris and rescued them. But she was determined that it was all Sri Rama's responsibility. It is not our responsibility to do all of that. So she was determined on that. Hence, even when Hanuman came to Pirati and said that, I am going to go back to Sri Rama anyway, let me carry you on my back. At that time she said, no, that is not proper. He has to come here, he has to win over Ravana and he has to rescue me and he has to accept me. That is the process. So she was firm on Bhagavan being the means to protect her. So here it is explained that Pirati gave up her own Shakti, her own ability to destroy Ravana and the Rakshasas in Lanka, and she was fully determined that it was Bhagavan's responsibility to do all of that. So this is exactly what is the ideal situation, where we are not depending on Karma Yogam, Jnana Yogam, Bhakti Yogam, Tirunama Sankirtanam. Because many times people ask, what are you? Are you a Bhakti Yogi? Are you practicing Tirunama Sankirtanam? And so on. But we say that we are not any of that. We are Sharanagatas, totally surrendered to Bhagavan through an Acharya. And this is because our elders have shown that path to us. So Pirati gave up her own Shakti. Draupadi gave up her Lajja, her shyness, when she was in the assembly, dragged to the assembly by Dushasan. She called out for Krishna. They were trying to unrobe her. At that time she cried out in a helpless manner. She lifted her arms up and cried out to Bhagavan. She did not care about being unrobed there, because she had full faith in Bhagavan. She was not looking at herself. And it's actually explained in the commentary and by Pillalokacharya also, that Draupadi's act, mainly in the commentary, Mamnigal brings out this point, Draupadi's act was even greater than Pirati's act, because Pirati is Sri Mahalakshmi herself, Sita Pirati is Mahalakshmi herself, she knows about Bhagavan fully, so there is nothing great about Pirati doing that staying put in Lanka, knowing that anyway Bhagavan is going to come and rescue her. But Draupadi, being a bound soul, having full faith in Bhagavan, just because she heard a few good words from some rishis previously, saying that whenever there is a problem, you always fully depend on Krishna. So she, in spite of being a bound soul, having that full faith and giving up all shyness and lifting her hands up, not trying to cover herself up or protect her, that is even greatly glorified here. And then there is Tirukkannamangai Aandaan, who gave up all his duties, all his activities, when he observed that a particular incident happened in Tirukkannamangai where he was staying. A person's dog misbehaved in some way and with a particular neighbor, and the neighbor hurt that dog and killed it, and this owner of the dog, he killed that person being angry upon him, and then he also killed himself fearing the punishment of the king. Seeing all of this, Tirukkannamangai Aandaan realized, if someone can kill another person just for harming his dog and also kill himself fearing punishment of the king, how much love he has towards his dog. And we, being Atmas who are totally subservient to Bhagavan, how much love should Bhagavan have for us? In such case, should I be doing anything for my own prosperity, my own health, wealth, and so on, my own protection? So he, at that point, he gives up all his activities, all activities which are his own, for his own sake, not for, he did not give up temple Kaikariyams, he did not give up Kaikariyams to Bhagavatas, but he gave up all activities which are for taking care of his own body, his own prosperity and so on. And he fully committed himself for Bhagavat Kaikariyams. He never looked back. Yes, sometimes people misinterpret it and say that he gave up all activities and just was crawling and staying in the temple and so on, and somebody was coming and feeding him and so on. It's not like that, because there are incidents in the commentaries where it is highlighted that Tirukkannamangai Aandaan was actually sweeping the temple floor, and when someone comes and asks, you are someone who are fully dedicated to Bhagavan, who gave up all your activities, now why are you cleaning this place? And for that, Tirukkannamangai Aandaan says, you see, before cleaning the place, it was dirty, now it is clean. That is the only purpose of my act. There is no other expectation. So, we are not doing Kaikariyam expecting anything else, but we are doing Kaikariyam only for the sake of doing Kaikariyam. So, all these three personalities, they are ideal examples for Upayam. How to accept Bhagavan as the only means for us, and we will not do even a small act for our own benefit. So everything should be submitted to Bhagavan. So that is Upayam aspect. Now we come to our topic here, Upayam. Upayam, for Upayam, four personalities are highlighted. Ilaya Perumal, Lakshmana, Periyudayar, Jatayu Maharaja, Pillai Thirunarayur Ariyar, and then there is Chintayanti, a Gopika. Now, Ilaya Perumal, Lakshmana, was so immersed in Kaikariyam that he would not care for himself at all. He went with Perumal and Pirati to the forest. He surrenders to Perumal and tells him, I will come with you and Pirati to the forest, and you both of you can enjoy in the forest while I will take care of all your requirements. I will do all the chores. So that was his vow, and he never slept throughout the stay in forest. He always accompanied Perumal, he always served him, he took care of all the activities. And because he was doing Kaikariyam alone and doing everything for Perumal, even after returning to Ayodhya after the 14 years of exile, he was always engaged in doing multiple Kaikariyams. So that is highlighted in the 83rd Sutram by Pillai Lokacharya, that Ilaya Perumal, Lakshmana, would carry umbrella in one hand and fan in another hand and serve in all possible ways to Perumal even after returning, because he is always used to doing so many things for Perumal. So here, his dedication to Kaikariyam, always being engaged in Kaikariyam irrespective of whatever situation he is in, is highlighted. Next is Jatayu Maharaja, who gave up his own body fighting Ravana when he saw that Pirati was being carried away by Ravana. Jatayu Maharaja was a very dear personality to Perumal. Perumal considered him as his father's elder brother. That is how Sri Rama treated Jatayu Maharaja as. And when Jatayu Maharaja saw Ravana carrying Pirati away, he went and fought with him. Even though Jatayu Maharaja was very, very old at that time, he didn't have all his strength, but he still did not want to give up. In the end, to be only heavily harmed by Ravana, and he fell down. And when Sri Rama comes and asks what happened, and he explains all of what happened, and Perumal performs the final rites for Jatayu Maharaja in the end. So here, in spite of his difficulties, very old age, and Ravana being a very powerful fighter, he did not mind all of that. He did not think about all of that. He just went and did his duty, and he succumbed in the end. Pillai Thirunarayur Ariyar's situation is a little bit different. Pillai Thirunarayur Ariyar was someone coming in the Ariyar family. Ariyars are those who sing in front of Perumal with thalam, cymbals in their hands. He was serving in a temple named Thottiyam Thirunarayanapuram. This is a town near Srirangam. He was serving in the temple there. And once some miscreants set fire to the temple, and even the deity, the main Perumal there, was in danger of being caught in the fire. At that time, Pillai Thirunarayur Ariyar brought his family as well. He went and tried his best to to protect the temple and the Perumal. And finally, he decided that there is only way he can protect the Perumal by fully covering the Perumal by embracing him and stopping the fire from reaching Perumal. So he did that, and not only he did himself, he also got his children to do the same. And when the children was asking, "It is very hot here, we are not able to bear it," at that time Pillai Thirunar Ayyar says, "Just hold on for a few moments, we will be in Paramapadam soon and we will have endless joy there. This difficulty is only for a few moments." So Pillai Thirunar Ayyar in the end gave up his own life and his family's life in protecting Perumal. So that was his Kaikariyam. He was totally forgetting about the bodily difficulties, situations, and he was only focused on his Kaikariyam of protecting Perumal. Finally, Chintayanti is a Gopika. She was a very dear Gopika for Krishna. Once on a night, Krishna was playing the flute. Chintayanti was hearing that and she wanted to immediately go towards Krishna. She started coming out of her room and she saw all her in-laws, husband, everyone was sitting in the hall, and she became very anguished. She could not leave the home at that time, fearing her in-laws. So as she felt great suffering, anguish in her mind, all her sins got eliminated. We suffer due to our sins, and she had such great suffering in that moment of separation from Krishna, being not able to reach him, all her sins got eliminated. And having heard Krishna's flute, she got so much bliss, and we get enjoyment due to our punyas, virtues, and she enjoyed so much bliss that all her punya got exhausted. And as punya and papa got exhausted for her, she at once left her body and ascended to Paramapadam immediately. So that was her mental state, that the fact that she was thinking about Bhagavan, she did not do anything beyond that. Just the thought itself, the deep emotions towards Bhagavan Krishna, made her go through great anguish and great bliss, and she left her body. So in all of these incidents, in these four personalities, the importance of Kaikariyam is greatly emphasized. How one can do Kaikariyam in different situations, even in dire situations, one can engage in Kaikariyam, whether it is in bodily Kaikariyam or Manasika Kaikariyam or Kaikariyam by speech. One can engage in Kaikariyam. Pillalokacharya also further explains a very important point. Here, in Shastram it is said that someone giving up their life for Bhagavan is also a means. It is actually explained in Shastram that if someone gives up their life for the sake of Bhagavan, for protecting Bhagavan or in some activity, then they will get mukti, liberation. So a question is raised here. Is it possible that Pillai Thirunar Ayyar or Jatayu Maharaja or Chintayanti, all three who gave up their lives in thinking about, in serving Bhagavan, did they do it knowingly that if I give up my life, then I will get liberation? And it is explained in the commentary by Mamnigal beautifully that had they known that if it is to be done as a means to attain Bhagavan, then they would not have done it. Because again, they are firmly in the principle that Only Bhagavan is the means. No other means should be pursued by us. It is because of their overwhelming love they did these acts. It is not because at that time thinking, oh, there is only 2 minutes left now. If I embrace Bhagavan and protect myself, protect Bhagavan from the fire, I will get Parampadam. Pilaitrinarayar Araya did not think like that. He was only thinking about Bhagavan and he was only thinking about Kaikariyam. So it is explained that it is Raga Praptam. It is out of love. All of these personalities engaged in Kaikariyam, even ignoring their own body. So this sutram, these set of sutrams are very, very enlightening and very, very inspirational for us. So how we engage in Kaikariyam, how we look up to our Purvacharyas in this particular aspect of Kaikariyam, how they have done Kaikariyams in spite of many, many hurdles, we can see the lives of our Acharyas, Emperumanar, how he actually went to Trinaranapuram and established our Sampradayam in that region when he was placed in a very difficult situation. So how Pillalokacharya had to carry Emperuman, Namperumal, towards a southern direction when the invaders were attacking Sri Rangam. He was very old at that time, more than 100 years old. So he was willing to serve Bhagavan even at that old age, doing very difficult task of traveling through difficult terrains, through forests, where there is all the possibility of being attacked by robbers, attacked by wild beasts and so on. So many of our Acharyas did so much for Kaikariyam. So we have to think about it in this manner, why it is important to choose engaging in Kaikariyams over just doing our duties. Yes, doing our duties is important, but at the same time we have to progressively change from the mode of doing duties only in a ritualistic manner or even in a dedicated manner, just doing duties only. Change from that, transform from that to engaging in Kaikariyam fully, dedicating our life for Bhagavan, Bhagavatas and Acharyas. That transformation will happen over time. It will not happen on one sudden occasion, but it will happen progressively. We have to think about it every time we engage in Kaikariyams. We have to think about how to improve it, how to progress it, how to make it better, and how to increase the time in Kaikariyam. This Kaikariyam will include keeping our family together, engaging everyone in Kaikariyam. It's an inclusive process. It's not like if we are engaging in Kaikariyam, we are abandoning our family. It is not like that. As Grihasthas, we have to engage in Kaikariyam together. Everyone in the family should be encouraged, should be taught, should be given the proper education about Kaikariyam, why it is important for the Atma to be engaging in Kaikariyam. That aspect, most often the parents specifically miss to explain that principle to children. They do things, they go to temple, they even perform Kaikariyam in the mutt, in the Acharya Tirumalgai or Acharya's mutt. They go to temple and even engage in Kaikariyam. They go to temple, recite pasurams, and without expectation they may even be doing it. But sometimes they fail to explain that, all of that process, to the children. And because of that, the children always grow up with a mindset that we do this because our parents told us to do. we do this because it is something we have to do. They don't really enjoy it. They don't really feel a part of it. And for that, we have to first feel a part of being in Kaikeyiam. We have to understand our own responsibility and our own duty in being involved in Kaikeyiam fully in a dedicated manner, and we have to transmit that knowledge to the next generation as well. If we don't teach our kids about all these important good things, they will learn something else from outside and they'll think that is greater and bigger than what we are gifted by our acharyas. Our acharyas have given us the best gift. It's holistic, it's comprehensive. We have Kaikeyiams for the mind, we have Kaikeyiams for the speech, we have Kaikeyiams for the body, and it's available for everyone. Everyone has, irrespective of the varna and ashrama, everyone has Kaikeyiam for the mind, everyone has Kaikeyiam for the speech, everyone has Kaikeyiam for the body. It is not that some people are just there to recite pasrams and once that is done, they run towards their homes. It is not like that. I mean, people may be doing it, but that's not the intention of our acharyas. And it's not that there is one set of persons who are only there to clean the temple. It's not that one set of person is only supposed to be sitting at their own place and meditating on Perumal only. No, everyone has to have involvement in all these aspects. Whether it is a sannyasi, whether it is a brahmachari, whether it is a grihastha, whether it is a brahmana, kshatriya, vaishya, shudra, male, female, child, older person, everyone has Kaikeyiams for all the three faculties, mind, body and speech. We just have to find out, we just have to know, and we have to share this with others who are interested, how to engage in Kaikeyiams through body, how to engage in Kaikeyiams through speech, how to engage in Kaikeyiams through mind, how to serve Bhagavan, how to serve Acharyas, how to serve other Bhagavatas. All of these should be explored and understood. Just like we go to school, we learn things from 9 in the morning till 4 o'clock in the evening, study so many subjects, do so many experiments. We spend so much time in all of that for the bodily survival and bodily comforts. Similarly, for the survival of the Atma and bliss of the Atma, comfort of the Atma, we have to spend time in learning and practicing what we learned as well. Also, when it comes to Kaikeyiams, we have to see where we are needed. Sometimes there may be 10 people reciting pasurams, but the person who is in the kitchen cooking may be alone. Similarly, there may be 10 persons assisting the acharya, but in the temple there may be only 2 people. And vice versa. Maybe there is 10 people in the temple, but only 1 person with the acharya. So, all of these happen. There is imbalance in Kaikeyiams within our own self as well as Kaikeyiams across the various platforms. There is always imbalance. And we tend to go where there is crowd. But that is really a big problem. We like to be part of the crowd. We like to be part of the place where it's happening rather than where it is needed. So we have to use our intelligence and analyze the situations and see where best we can be and what Kaikeyiam we can do. At the same time, we should not be going to take up a Kaikeyiam where we are not equipped with, the ability which is required for that particular Kankeriyam. Not everyone will be made for all Kankeriyams. So we have to see what is our capability, what is our capacity, what is our situation, and where is the need. And depending on all of that, we have to choose Kankeriyams. A lot of things have been discussed, so everyone can contemplate on all of these and see what is best for each one of us, and we can try to practice that. With that, Adiyan will stop today, and if there are any questions, we can discuss them and address them. Alvar Embarumanar, G.R. Thiruvadigalai Sharanam, G.R. Thiruvadigalai Sharanam.
To learn such valuable information about our Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya, please download Koyil, K-O-Y-I-L app from Google Play Store or Apple App Store. Our website is koyil.org, K-O-Y-I-L.org.